I'm Maria, and today I'm going to show you how to fix a 406 error. Server and client-side errors happen occasionally, and we commonly refer to them as HTTP responses or status codes. The 406 error or 406 not acceptable error is one such HTTP response. You may see the 406 error while visiting a site, or worse, on your website. Besides looking somewhat unprofessional and confusing, any HTTP response code, including the 406 error, can lose sales and users. In this video, we will go over how to fix the 406 error. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. So, let's get started. It's prudent to run a website or application backup before completing any steps to resolve a 406 error. There's always the potential for causing further problems by going into your site's source code, so you'll want to have a database and site file backup to restore if necessary. Make sure you complete a full backup with everything from the database to the application and the media elements to the site files. If you're a Kinsta user, you can do this with the My Kinsta Backup feature, which logs your entire website in a separate file and has a restore button for later use. Now it's time to talk about the best methods to troubleshoot the error and prevent it from happening again. These tactics include taking a look at client-side causes, where a user makes an error or the machine isn't working correctly, and server-side causes and platform-based causes like faulty plugins. Our first piece of advice may sound simple, but it's the quickest troubleshooting option and it puts a focus on issues with the client side of things, i.e. your computer. A 404 error is far more likely than a 406 error in this situation, but you may end up seeing a 406 not acceptable error if the website URL is valid. Yet there's something odd about the way your browser translates to the request. For instance, adding JSON or PHP to the end of your URLs could be misinterpreted as a request for those particular formats, even though the client doesn't need them. To resolve the issue, double-check the previous used URL that produced the error. Try typing it in again or opting for a different subdomain on the website to see if it's the only one page that isn't rendering. A 406 message is technically considered a client-side error code, even though it's often a platform or server issue. So this is the first course of action to determine if something's wrong on the client side. Another client-side problem occasionally involves the accept headers sent from the user's computer to a platform that can't satisfy the request. Many of these platforms include gaming or media-oriented systems like Hulu or music marketplaces like Spotify. In simpler terms, you may log into a platform like Hulu, try to watch your favorite TV show, and receive a 406 error message. In this example, the problem is almost always on the client side. It's usually your computer, network, or another device you've used to launch the platform. Media and gaming platforms are complicated with many restrictions, and those restrictions depend on your location or network configuration. There's a chance you might encounter an error like this due to all of the moving pieces. Although we can't help you troubleshoot every specific platform, consider walking through the following recommendations and checking to see if the error resolves. Go online to check the status of your platform server. It may simply be a problem with the company's server. Restart your computer, gaming system, streaming device, or other machines. Disconnect all devices from their cables, wait a few minutes before reconnecting them all, and check to see if the error is gone. Check if the app is running the most current version. Also, see if any of your machines have firmware updates available. Reset your home or office network, the Wi-Fi or internet connection through your router. Consider switching from a wireless network to a wired network connection if you're still having trouble. And although this isn't always a possibility, consider duplicating the error with a completely different machine. Make sure that the device is on the same network. If you can't replicate the error, look into your network in the original machine. If all else fails, go to your search engine and type in the name of your platform along with +406 error code for platform-specific troubleshooting advice. That often reveals forums and support documentation to guide you through the process. Next, it's time to explore the system used for your websites or applications. You may find that your content management system, such as WordPress, is a direct cause of a 406 not acceptable error due to a complication with something inside your site files. Whether using WordPress or any other content management system, look into when your last update occurred. WordPress has a sturdy default infrastructure meant to avoid these types of errors, no matter what. However, specific plugins, themes, or manually adjusted coding could produce situations where the site files violate client or server requests. A simple upgrade to your CMS's latest version can solve the problem right away. To figure out if it's your CMS, start by rolling back any recent upgrades that occurred to the core files. As you may already know, WordPress sends out updates to its system regularly. Most of these updates happen automatically, but older versions still require you to click a button. Furthermore, WordPress and other CMSs utilize several moving parts like plugins, themes, and extensions. Those also get updated regularly, so you might need to roll back some of them. For all systems outside of WordPress, search for platform name plus how to downgrade. If you use WordPress, you can easily downgrade your WordPress website, effectively rolling it back to one of the previous versions. Check out the following methods for downgrading your WordPress site, most of which only take a few minutes. Manually downgrading your WordPress site. Using a plugin to complete the WordPress system downgrade. Restoring a previous backup to bring back an old version or at least the content and files from before. Manually downgrading a theme or plugin. And downgrading a plugin or theme with a separate plugin. WordPress plugins and themes add extra code to your site files that interact with the core WordPress files. Reputable plugins typically don't cause any problems, but occasionally a conflict might occur. That's why, in some cases, a plugin theme or third-party extension may be the reason for the 406 error. The tried-and-true method for identifying a troublesome plugin or theme is to deactivate your plugins and themes one by one. After disabling each, check to see if the 406 error has vanished. If so, you've found the problem. If it doesn't go away, reinstall the plugin or theme and continue uninstalling the next one. Important note here, start with your plugins, then move to the theme. Uninstalling and reinstalling a theme has more significant potential for content rearrangement. Unfortunately, a removed problem plugin could still affect your WordPress database, since plugins get full access to the database to work well. Therefore, you should still check the status of your database even if it appears the removal of a plugin has made the 406 error go away. Otherwise, you may still run the risk of seeing further issues in the future. If a plugin or theme wasn't the culprit, you should also check your database if it's the primary source of the error. Sometimes a database change, whether accidental or purposeful, becomes the primary reason a 406 error appears. To scan and fix your database, consider installing a database scanner and cleaner that removes useless and troublesome tables and assets. Some options include WP Optimize and the Advanced Database Cleaner. Much of this process involves deleting old or orphaned items like trash posts, revisions, and metadata. It's a solid first step to cleaning up your database and potentially eliminating that 406 error. Possibly, scan the database and look for records and tables potentially changed by a problematic plugin or ones that look out of place or unnecessary. Or if you have an idea of what's wrong with your database, reach out to your hosting provider and ask for help. The previous recommendations focus on client-side and CMS-oriented troubleshooting. Now, we'll consider all server-side issues. The first step in troubleshooting the server is checking the logs. It doesn't matter what type of web application, CMS, or web design system you use. They all have server-side logs. The application logs store that web application's entire or recent history, with information about each database inquiry, results provided, pages requested, and much more. On the other hand, the server logs contain information about the health and status of the server or hardware used to run the web application. For Kinsta users, you can find error and server logs in the My Kinsta dashboard. Check all logs that may be causing the 406 error and that you could find in the error.log file, the Kinsta cacheperf.log file, or the access.log file. To see the three necessary logs, click on the Sites tab, choose your site, then the Logs button, along with the type of log from the drop-down menu. You can also check raw access and WordPress error log files with an FTP client. Other options include enabling error logs in wp-config.php and going through the debug mode in the MyKinsta dashboard. If you have problems finding the error logs or don't know how to interpret them, contact the Kinsta customer support team for assistance. Like most web applications have server and error logs, they also typically provide information about debugging the application itself. Debugging involves going through the application's code to find and eliminate minor errors or bugs. One of the best ways to run a complete scan of WordPress and any other web application for that matter is to debug the database and website files. Luckily, debugging doesn't mean you have to read through every line of code and pick out the bugs yourself. Programs are available for this specific purpose. And as we mentioned earlier, Kinsta even has its debugging tool within the MyKinsta dashboard. Start the debugging process by learning the basics of debugging WordPress with the Kinsta debug mode, WordPress debug plugins, or a manual process. You can fix the 406 error in several ways. As long as you know what you are seeing and where to look for the fix, you should be able to clear the error up. Do you have any other recommendations for resolving 406 not acceptable errors? Please share them in the comments below. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your site by up to 200%. And you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our MyKinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.